episode 88, Sneaker Box Podcast. What's going on? It's been a crazy weekend. I got my fives, and it was remarkably easy. This might be the first time in many years I was able to go into the store late and just pick up my size in the shoe.
I guess you thought we cared.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I care,
let's start over. Okay. Welcome to episode 88 of Sneaker Box Podcast.
Probably because it was 105 degrees and everybody went late.
That's true.
You have so much water in your belly, you probably was able to live off of that.
I'm a while camel.
Other people dehydrated.
Just call me a camel. there was a lot of people, though, because some stores had full size runs, and a lot of people who got the raffles didn't even show up.
It was too hot to buy shoes, man.
I had actually won the raffle, but between like the two events, I wasn't even able to.
How was it,
bro? It was dope, man. They was dope.
Man, stupid. Okay, I'm gonna say that for another show, but Chrysler need to get their stuff together. Anyway, this is the Sneaker Box Podcast. I am the African Caesar.
All hail Caesar, Emperor of Rome, Monarch of the Roman Empire, Ruler of the World.
Hail Caesar!
All right, and ironically sitting to my left, my right-hand man, Juan Neal.
In a world, one man.
It's Juan!
Oh yeah, special shout-out to my grandma who just turned 83 yesterday. And then RIP to my man's Willie Murray who passed away 3 years ago today. You know what I'm saying? My grandfather, best friend. So, you know. What's up, though, world?
What's up? All right, and last but not least, we got Trufe in the house. You know what? Hey. I see Step Brothers is getting a lot of play at y'all's right now.
Man, shout out to the summertime. That's all I'm going
to
say.
Hey. Shout out to it, bro. Ain't nothing like it.
I went to Six Flags in Marlboro, Maryland this weekend, and there was a lot of water and a lot of,
a lot of wetness.
Shout out to y'all, man. Although my trip got overcast, I got stuck down there for.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw y'all post. What was the weather?
No, Southwest Airlines had a computer glitch on Wednesday.
Wow.
And it like pushed back a bunch of stuff, but they was cool about it. They gave me a free round trip flight voucher to wherever I wanted to go.
So that ain't bad.
It worked out.
That worked. I'll take it. It seemed like I had two athletes die this weekend, didn't we?
No, Coach Green died.
Yeah, somebody died in a Denny car Green. Crash.
Yeah. Oh, that was two punters.
Yeah.
From Michigan State.
Yeah, State, and I forgot what the other school was.
Man. Like I said, crazy weekend. All right, so anyway, this is the Sneaker Box Podcast with Sneaker Bar Detroit. Partner with Crep Protect. What's the point of spending all that money in your shoes if you're not going to keep them clean long enough to get your money's worth? Practice safe snotting. Go to crepprotect.com and get your shoes some protection. Also, make sure to follow us on Instagram at @TheSneakerBox_podcast, on Twitter at @The_Sneaker_Box, and on Facebook at The Sneaker Box Podcast. And if you'd like to talk to us live, you can call us every Monday from 11 to noon Eastern Standard Time at 888-799-5267. The Sneaker Box top 10 releases from the previous week.
A fucking ten.
All right, number 10, you have the Trap Star Special Edition Puma Disc Blaze Camo Barb Cherry. It's one of those shoes you're either going to really like it or you're going to really hate it.
That's why it's at number 10.
Yep. Number 9, I'm waiting to see your reaction. Pharrell Special Edition Adidas NMD Human Race.
Oh, yeah. A human race full of orthopedic shoes.
I actually had them in my cart and just didn't buy it.
Oh, you didn't put a trigger on those?
Probably would have made you some
just wasn't impressed.
Yeah.
That's a nice shoe, but somebody actually admitted it. I don't know if it's my man's from L.A., but they look nice in hand. On feet, not so much.
Yeah, when NMDs make you more money than Jordans.
All right. Crazy. Number 8, Bait and DreamWorks Special Edition Diadora N9000 Felix the Cat. Number 7, the Ewing Eclipse Olympic Pack.
Those was dope.
Those was hot.
Wasn't the gold ones and
it was a blue. It was a white
Olympic one.
Yeah, it was a white red and blue pair, and then it was like a navy blue with like
the stars.
The bottoms was dope though. Like the outsole was like this.
But did it come with the gold medal like back in the day? Mm. When I was a kid, my Uncle Kevin, who's in town right now, mm-hmm. he bought me those, man. And it actually came with a gold medal.
I don't think they came with a gold medal. Yeah. They did.
Great job,
that'd
Patrick.
That'd have been crazy. Number six, the Puma Trinomic Zip High Risk Red. Real dope shoe.
Say that three times fast.
Yeah, I'm not.
It's pronounced Gordon.
I said it right the first time.
I actually didn't. I don't even know what you're reading. Puma Trinomic
Zip High Risk Red.
I thought you had went to the next page.
Number five, you had the ASICS Jet Light 3 Mango. Number four, you had the Air Jordan Retro 5 Metallic Silver. Which, I don't know how they did everywhere else. They did okay. I thought there would be more of a hyped release, though, you know, with the Nike Air on the back of the heel, so... wasn't as crazy as I thought it would be. Number three, you have the Wale and Vela Special Edition ASICS Gel Light 3 Intercontinental.
Those are dope.
Yes.
Wale can't lose, bro, when it comes to designing shoes. Right.
Nope.
He just had a baby, too.
Did he? Oh, yeah, I saw that. Was it a boy or girl?
Girl.
That's what's up.
Shame on you, bro.
Number two, you have the Air Jordan Retro 2 Quad 54, but that was an overseas release.
Wow.
I'm trying to get my hands on those. Wish me luck.
But your overseas shipping probably be crazy, bro. Because it's like
$50.
It's like a weight limit, right?
See, you funny. But no, I got charged like $50 for shipping.
His shoes can't come in planes.
did you see that 24 karat gold OVO 10 they did for Drake and it weighed like 100 pounds? Like, yeah. How did they ship that, bro?
I don't know. At that point, you would just think he would just drive it to him. Like, I'll meet you somewhere. And number one. You have the Nike Air Foamposite 1 Premium Olympic. Our drummer is going to get his money's worth, I guess. Excuse me. Ugliest release of the week.
Super ugly.
The Under Armour Curry 2.5 49ers.
I don't even know why he did it, bro.
Yep. I don't know what
they might as well just put this as like the Under Armour version of the Spike 40.
Basically.
Yeah, everything all of them is bad.
I'm going to go back and see. Like, there has to be... I'm guessing the Spike 40 has the record as far as being on the ugliest release of the week. But I'm thinking these Under Armour Curry 2.5s are definitely making a run for that.
Well, I guess Curry going to win something, huh?
I went to the Under Armour headquarters while I was down there.
How was it?
It was dope. They got a the swimming pool and all that junk. It's a basketball court, football field. Like, it's dope.
Yeah, because anybody can go into the facility, right?
Like,
yeah.
It's like an actual gym. And they Champs got something. You know how we got, like, the house, like, the Jordan Flight 23 stores or whatever?
Yeah.
The Champs in Maryland has this part in the back of the store called the Armory. It's like a whole Under Armour section.
Oh, that's actually kind of sounding dope.
Listen, they sportswear is dope, bro. But they can keep those shoes.
Your shoes. I'm trying to. Like, I'm trying to find something nice to say, and I just can't find it.
Don't say nothing at all.
There you go.
I'll say all the bad stuff.
ugly honorable mentions. You have the Kim Jones Special Edition Nike Lab Packable Sports Style Collection. Trash. Nike Women's. The ladies are just taking L's this past week. You got the Nike Women's Air Huarache Ultra Liquid Finish. And then you have the Nike Women's Zoom Pegasus 92 Night Maroon.
Too much.
Yeah, way too much. Also, too, random piece of overpriced bullshit.
Smell like a pile of bullshit!
Yeah, what he said. You had the Rick Owens Special Edition Adidas Mastodon. No joints going for $618.
These look like the greatest, most comfortable orthopedic shoes ever. this look like the breakdancing shoe for the man transitioning from 70 to 80.
Shout out to Calvin.
I mean, they're not horrible. They're just not worth $620.
No, there's more back end in this shoe sticking out than Nicki Minaj.
Wow.
I am not with this shoe, bro. Look at this.
Those insoles are thick. Midsoles?
The midsoles.
The midsoles are thick, dude. It's, them like platform sneakers. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Nicki Minaj is thick, too.
Yes, bro.
Just going to stick with that theme. Yeah, man, it's them joints. I'm not even sure you're going to feel. If you walked over rocks, I don't think you would feel them.
Yeah, just like my man's was about to glue it evenly. Was just like, fuck it. I'm just going to throw them boys off. It's my last day working here anyways.
Wow. Stuck caring.
Right.
They like the PL Flyers that Benny jumped over the fence with.
All
right, so yeah, that wraps that up.
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Mike Ricks, man. And you're listening to the number one sneaker show, the Sneaker Box Podcast with SneakerBarDetroit.com. Hey, you want some good talk? Listen to my boys. Get you some. Yes, gone.
All right, so 2 years ago, I wasted my money because the OG Air Jordan 1 Black Toe is set to re-release later this year. There's two things. I want people to notice something because this has been my beef with the Air Jordan 1s when they started doing the first run of the Nike Air is that the height and cut was still a mid, well, a little bit taller than a mid. It wasn't the exact height of the OG 1. And so what they're doing is, I guess, coming back out with the original colorways in that original height of the Air Jordan 1. So the Black Toe, it would be dope if they come out with the black and gold joints.
Yeah.
If they bring those back, because that's why I'm kind of, I want to go after the ones they got, they came out already, but I'm holding back because as soon as I buy them for like $1,000, then
they are definitely going for $1,700.
At least. And so as soon as I do that, they're going to come out with re-retro the black and gold joints, so I'm going to hold off, but these Black Toes are set to be released this year. They don't have an exact release date, but keep your eyes peeled for them. Fat Joe is opening a sneaker store with a teenager, just a random teenager somewhere.
That's dope.
In an article written by Nate Lewis.
Or as we call him in England, St. Louis.
Oh, St. Louis. Well, I got a new writer over there, Soul Collector. Fresh out of high school, Scotty Spina will be partnering with Fat Joe to open a brick-and-mortar store in New York New York City. Scotty, who goes by Scotty Kicks with a Z. What's up with everybody just spelling stuff with a Z? Said he was originally introduced to Fat Joe through a mutual friend. Eventually, he became Fat Joe's shoe plug. Scotty Kicks with a Z said it all began one day in 2013 when he went to the mall with a couple of friends to buy the Kilroy Air Jordan 9. After waiting hours in line, he finally got in the Foot Locker and purchased the shoe, but he noticed that some people were walking out of the store with three or four pairs. After asking his friend why, Scotty Kicks with a Z, learned that they were going to resell the shoes for profit. A few months later, Scotty Kicks with a Z was off to the races selling shoes through his Instagram account and Craigslist. Do people still use Craigslist to sell shoes now?
People use Craigslist to set people up.
That's what I was going to say. This must have been many years ago.
Yo, quick question. Why aren't you wearing shoes, caveman?
He said things really took off when he got an Instagram DM from former New York Giant Brandon Jacobs asking him about a pair of shoes. Brandon didn't even believe how young Scotty Kicks with a Z was and asked if he could deliver the shoes to the Giants facility. From there, Brandon spread the word to his teammates, and Scotty Kicks with a Z began to gain notoriety among other athletes and friends. This led him connecting with entertainers and gaining relationships that would be important to his business. Scotty Kicks with a Z claims he's already made six figures on sneaker reselling. I don't know. I hear a lot of people saying that they make six figures. Is it that lucrative? You would think so many people are doing it wouldn't be that lucrative.
It's not about what you know, it's who you know.
I guess. But declined to give exact numbers. He also plans to start college this fall to get a degree in business. There is no exact timetable for the New York store to open.
Scotty.
We're still cool.
It is a waste to go to college, bro. You have already made six figures. There is no reason for you to go to college. There is nothing that college can teach you that you don't already know.
Never go full retard.
Exactly. You're already an entrepreneur. You're already moving weight.
Just take some tax classes.
Yeah.
Converse just released Chuck Taylors with a wah-wah pedal in them. Am I saying that right? Wah-wah pedal?
Man, I don't know.
That's how it looks.
Wah-wah pedal is.
I think it explains it in the story. Let me see. Okay, in an article written by Riordan Lee and Techley.com AU. Converse is using some sort of rock wizardry to fit a pair of Chuck Taylors with a wah-wah pedal called the Chet Atkins All-Wah. For the uninitiated, a wah pedal is a little machine that makes classic, I'm not making that sound, that wah sound electric guitars make.
That wah-wah-wah-wah.
I guess. Okay, I'm not playing that. For the past few years, Converse has teamed up with Cute Circuit, working on a shoe with an inbuilt wah pedal that hooks up to your guitar. After a few different prototypes, they've come up with the final product. This is how it works. Plug a guitar and amp cable into the dual plugs into the size of your shoe. A flex sensor installed in the insole senses how much someone is flexing their foot, then uses Bluetooth technology to send this information to the wah box. If you don't have an amp, it can also plug into a Mac or iPhone. There are only 23 pairs available, and Converse hasn't released any details yet on how you can get your hands on them. So stay tuned to SneakerBirdieTrade.com for more information as it develops. So if you're into playing guitars,
it'll sell out among the artists.
Oh, yeah, easily. I mean, there's only 23 pairs, so I'm guessing. I mean, I don't think anybody normal is going to get their hands on them. Nike's working on his own augmented reality app. An article written by Riley Jones for Soul Collector.
Don't you dare call me Curry.
Nike's been hard at work perfecting an augmented reality app of his own. Nike's plan for augmented reality sneaker customization was first brought to light last year, and now, as noted by Investors Business Daily, the brand's closer than ever to making it happen. Nike filed a continuation for his previous patent on July 5th, updating his plans for a system that allows a user to create a design for an article in real time using a proxy. In other words, you'll be able to customize a sneaker straight from your phone with a lifelike model. As futuristic as this all may sound, Nike's subsidiary, Converse, had an augmented reality app way back in 2010 that allowed people to sample shoes and see what they would look like on foot before purchasing. So it doesn't really seem like they're really coming up with anything new. It just seems like they just took whatever Converse had and just put Nike on it.
That's Nike Mongo.
Yeah, that's Nike Mongo.
Converse and Nike still under the same company, aren't they?
Yeah. So, I mean, but it sounds like, I remember Chrysler, when Daimler ran Chrysler, they had these ovens in the paint booths that they had. It was like infrared ovens. Anyway, they took those and replaced them with like these like steam ovens instead of the infrared. And it just seems like whenever you get these big companies that buy these smaller companies, they take whatever's good and then dip. So, in any event.
You own it, take it.
There you go. Adidas sold 11,000 pairs of the Ultra Boost uncaged in 1 hour. Mm. Ooh. Adidas get a ooh. An article written by Brandon Doon for Soul Collector.
Awkward silence.
According to Adidas, it sold 11,000 pairs of his Ultra Boost uncaged in the first hour of his release, making it the fastest selling Adidas performance shoe ever in America. Adidas Senior Director of Running in North America, Paul Boyer, cast the success of the shoe as part of a larger momentum shift for the brand in the running category. He said, "The momentum we have in running is undeniable. Adidas has the best innovations in the industry with Boost, Primeknit, and now Bounce. And today, with the high style performance products and impactful execution, we're connecting with consumers like never before. We're seeing runners with Swoosh brands, athletes choose Adidas over our competitors, and sneakerheads demand a performance shoe. Adidas running will continue to accelerate, and we're eager to share what's next." The most popular Ultra Boost uncaged releases to date have been those with colored Boost cushioning on bottom. So, I think somebody even put a video up of how to color your Boost, and basically they just took a Sharpie and just colored it black.
That's not
like, it wasn't that deep.
You like that?
Yeah, I guess. Adidas, I guess simultaneously while they're selling out shoes, they're suing Skechers over another blatant sneaker ripoff. Skechers is there any original shoe Skechers has come out with?
Bro, I feel like, if you're not cheating, you ain't trying. Keep going, Skechers.
That's the Jerry Jones model.
Yeah.
Is Jerry Jones a board member of Skechers? Like, an article written by Brandon New for Soul Collector.
Awkward.
A new filing by Adidas alleges that Skechers copied their Spring Blade sneaker with shoes like the Skechers Megaflex and Megablade. Court documents reference articles and YouTube comments in which it's clear that the public recognizes the similarity in the designs. It also presents fairly damning side-by-side comparisons of the two models. In the complaint filed in U.S. District Court in Portland, Oregon, Adidas is seeking damages in an amount sufficient to compensate Adidas for Skechers' infringement of the patents in suit, but not less than a reasonable royalty together with interest and costs. Adidas condemns Skechers in a strongly worded statement. "We would not stand by and allow others to blatantly copy our products and infringe on our valuable intellectual property. These shameless imitations tarnish the reputation of our brand and our people who work tirelessly to research and develop technical innovations, designs that help athletes make a difference." Okay, get over yourself, Adidas.
Yeah, whatever.
Exactly. Adidas previously sued Skechers over its lifting of the popular Stan Smith sneaker design. I forgot about that. They did sue him earlier about that. That was
heavy, bro.
Oh,
heavy.
My God.
I guess, mean, when you sue these people, whether you win or lose, do you really have to pay the money? Does it really matter?
I don't know how that works. How does that work?
Come get the money. That's what I would tell them. Come get it.
I mean, you know, at that point, the lawyers just keep pushing stuff back. That case might take 10 years to finally come to a conclusion. So I guess in the same courthouse, in the next courtroom, Under Armour will be there suing Uncle Martian. Under Armour sues copycat Uncle Martian brand for $15 million. An article written by Brandon Noon for Soul Collector. He's trying to get back in your good graces, man.
Jeez, dude.
Under Armour.
Give it up.
Under Armour has made good on his promise to vigorously pursue all business and legal courses of action against Chinese brand Uncle Martian by filing a massive lawsuit against the knockoff brand in Chinese court. Oh, well, good luck with that.
You're not going to win over there, bro.
No, you might as well just save your money. Yutang.
They getting sued next.
I know.
Knocking off Wu-Tang. Yutang.
Yutang Sports ain't nothing to fuck with. reports that Yutang Sports reports that Under Armour is seeking 100 million RMB. I guess that's the money they got over there. And damages that equates to roughly $15 million in U.S. for losses suffered from Uncle Martian's trademark infringements. Uncle Martian just sounds such a dumb name to name anything.
It sounds like a clothing brand back like when Kid Robot was out.
Yeah, it just sounds so stupid. Under Armour filed the lawsuit in late June. Uncle Martian launched this past April with the logo very close to Under Armour's and even a line of Steph Curry looking shoes. For his part, Uncle Martian says that it's not merely a ripoff of Under Armour. Okay, what are you then? Explain yourself. I guess I should read this. It's been in for a while. Under Armour, I guess, is getting the last laugh over Steph Curry's low-top sneakers. In an article written by Matt Welty for Complex, when the all-white low-top Steph Curry 2 was revealed by New York sneaker store Renarts, all of the online jokesters came out and had something to say about the shoes. The criticism mainly focused around them looking like they were made for nerdy dads or for elderly people. Under Armour simply could have been labeled as uncool and let itself become the mockery of the footwear industry, but they fought back. Steph was asked about the sneakers getting roasted online, and he said that they were
fire.
Fire. He even went as far as to put a flame emoji on his shoes during that one practice they had during, what was it, the finals?
Yeah, he should have drew a flame emoji on his hand.
Bum. Steph wasn't the only one from his Under Armour camp to support his shoes. And it wasn't the brand's PR camp either. Tom Brady decided to watch Game 6 of the NBA Finals with his Steph Curry's on his feet, which he shared on Facebook. He even put the straight fire drawing that Steph used. This was followed up by golfer Jordan Spieth and Michael Greller's post on Instagram with the Steph Curry's.
So they all Under Armour athletes.
Right.
They didn't buy those.
They got gifted some weak shoes. Nike can't sell LeBron James's and Kevin Durant's $200 sneakers, and that opens up a space in the sneaker market. That's exactly where Under Armour slid in. Kids want to be like Steph Curry, and their parents can afford his shoes. This is also why Nike has seen success with Kyrie Irving's line. His shoes are affordable, and they're easy to wear. The internet making jokes about Steph's shoes are helping Under Armour sales. According to Brandon Etler, who works at Finish Line as a creative strategist, contrary to internet trolls, the Steph Curry is doing really well. It's viewed as a top trending product on Finish Line's website.
A top
trending product.
It's pronounced Gordon.
How do you make it? Oh! I always wanted to make it to the trap.
Okay, here you go. A top trending product on Finish Line's website. That's no surprise considering Under Armour's basketball sales were up 754% thanks to Steph Curry's shoes. According to Forbes, even the heartbreaking loss of the NBA Finals aren't denting the Under Armour brand, at least not in the stock market. Shares actually are trading up, increasing about 3%. Rival Nike shares are also up, albeit just 2%, despite the fact that Cleveland Cavaliers star LeBron James is a Nike-backed athlete. So, I don't know. I guess the more you talk about, so I guess, what's that old saying? Bad publicity is still good publicity?
Yeah, I guess so, man. I guess when you rub shit on the ground, flowers grow.
it's called manure at that point. All right, so.
Yo, what's good? This is Bullet RC, and you're listening to the number one sneaker show, the Sneaker Boss Podcast, on SneakerBarDetroit.com.
All right. Well, since Keena's not here today, I guess I'll do sneaker stories to make you go.
Aww.
There you go.
Way to come through, Keena.
First of all, let's get one thing straight. Crack is cheap.
Oh, Keena came in just to say that.
I don't make too much money to ever smoke crack. Let's get that straight.
Excuse us.
We don't do crack. We don't do that. Crack is whack.
Aww. You came in just to say that, Keena. And then she left. She came in just to say that and left.
She's every woman, bro.
There you go.
Damn.
In an article written by Brandon Richard for Soul Collector.
Money making rich.
Recently, George Kiel III and the Kiel Colon Cancer Foundation hosted the 2016 Kick and Roll Classic at the Round Rock Sports Center in Texas. The event, which included a Nate Robinson Judge dunk contest this year, is a sneaker-themed basketball tournament put together to raise awareness for colon cancer and educate attendees about the disease. In addition to the fun-filled experience, participants have the opportunity to win unique prize packs for their on-court and on-foot performances. For the second straight year, the signature models for Kyrie Irving and Damian Lillard were included in the lineup. Customs made using the Nike ID and My Adidas platforms for both the Nike Kyrie 2 and the Adidas D Lillard 2 was styled in the nonprofit's colors and came with a set of Kiel Colon Cancer Foundation Blue Knot laces. You can go to kielcoloncancer.org for more information on how you can get involved in the battle against colon cancer.
Definitely dope.
Shout out to George Kiel on that one, too. Tourist gives homeless man the shoes off his feet. In an article written by Riley Jones for Soul Collector.
Don't you call me Curry.
A tourist in Guatemala was unknowingly filmed giving the Nikes off of his feet to a homeless man. After the deed, the Good Samaritan actually walked away barefoot. You can see the video on the Daily Mail's website. It was real cool. It was the guy, homeless guy, was just sitting there and asking for, you couldn't hear anything, but he was asking for something. And the guy just took his shoes off and gave him to him. So it was real dope. All right, so once again, I really don't want to jinx anything, but we are working our way towards a certain goal, and so we're going to be making a lot of changes to make the show better, and one of those changes
is me wearing pants.
That makes it better for us here in the studio.
Aww.
But
Barry Right Ranger sounds upset about that.
I know, he's upset. I know, he's he just snapped
you
his...
can't handle the truth.
He just snapped his fingers and said, darn.
You so stupid, Juan.
But no, so we're going to take a break. I guess each week we're going to play some music for you guys. So this will be the first of many shows with it. So get used to it. All right, so we're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
This is Caesar Spin.
Yeah. See ya.
Bus
if the Lord would forgive me and bury me a G. I couldn't let my adversaries worry me, and every single day is a test. Wear a bulletproof vest. There's still a nigga stressing over death. If I could choose when a nigga die, think I'll take a puff on the blunt and let my trigger fly. When every day is another death, with every breath it's a constant threat. So watch your step. You can be next if you want to. Who do you run to? Murdering niggas, look what it's come to. My memories bring me misery, and life is hard in the ghetto, it's insanity. I can't breathe, got me thinking what the hell got. Cause I done suffered so much, I'm feeling shell-shocked. In drive-bys and everyday thing, I don't lost too many homies to this motherfucking game. And Lord knows. They could. I never let them capture me. Done lost too many niggas to this gang banging. Homies died in my arms with his brains hanging. Fucked up, I had to tell him it was alright. And that's a lie, and he knew it when he shook and died. My God, even though I know I'm wrong, man. Hennessy make a nigga think he's strong, man. I can't sleep, so I stay up. Don't wanna fuck them bitches, try to calm me down. I ain't giving up. I'm getting lost in the weed, man. Getting high, living every day like I'm gonna die. I smoke a blunt to take the pain out, and if I wasn't high, I'd probably try to blow my brains out. Lord knows. Crep Protect, I put that shit on everything. Go to crepprotect.com and get your shoes some protection.
All right, this week in stupid.
Are you stupid or something?
I'm as stupid does.
All right, Adidas throws shade at Under Armour athletes. It seemed like all these brands, first it was Under Armour throwing shade at everybody else. Well, I guess they deserve it then, I guess. An article written by Brandon Newman for Soul Collector. Mark King, Adidas North America president, thinks that Under Armour's roster of athlete endorsers are too bland. Wow. In an interview with Yahoo Finance, Mark criticized Under Armour's players as not being all that interesting. He said, I think most of the athletes on Under Armour are kind of milquetoast. Jordan Spieth, Tom Brady, hey, they are great athletes. When you think about Carlos Correa and James Harden and some of these guys, that personality and really stand for being an individual, that unique positioning for us. That's unique positioning for us.
Are you serious, bro? James Harden?
That's what I said. I was like, man, like, I mean, you got Carlos Correa, James Harden.
Matter of fact, Carlos who?
Right. That's my point. I'm like, dude, like, I don't know. Mark did not mention by name Under Armour's biggest endorser, Steph Curry, in the interview. But Mark also said that Adidas is focused on athletes who are creators and that have individual personalities that try to carve out their own space.
That don't have their own individual shoes, James Harden.
Oh, wow. Okay, Adidas. All right. You were doing so well. Like, we just heard the story about you selling out the Boost and, like, Under Armour. Now you come out and say something stupid like that.
They get a blinking half star.
He said a blinking half star. Some guy made his own do-it-yourself Ultra Boost. An article written by Riley Jones for Soul Collector.
Don't call me Curry.
One sneakerhead was forced to get creative after striking out on the triple white Adidas Ultra Boost Uncaged. Designer at Studio Hagel, I guess that's on Twitter, shared his impressive do-it-yourself creation, which uses a sock, a piece of plastic, and what appears to be a carefully molded piece of styrofoam to mimic the Ultra Boost Uncaged signature boost cushioning. So, yeah, go look at it.
Effects are fake, bro.
Yeah.
That's sad, though, that you can make that out of those three things. Make something that close.
I mean, they don't look too far off. Like, at a quick glance, you would probably think they were real.
That just made people realize how ripped off they get.
Yeah.
Let's see what happens when it gets wet.
New York Foot Locker is looted by thieves. An article written by Brandon Noon for Soul Collector.
His auntie probably one of the thieves.
A video on World Star Hip Hop captures a looting at a Foot Locker in New York City. In the clip, Foot Locker employees do their best to block the doors of the store.
Stupid.
Before I'm out. Like, I'm not even going to try to fight. Like, Foot Locker ain't paying me that much.
I'm grabbing stuff myself.
Before a group of men break through them with what appears to be apparel and shoes in tow. New York sneaker stores have long been targets for thieves and have often reacted by only letting customers try on one shoe at a time.
I would have grabbed all the runners. Every last runner. Everybody been running for the Jordans and stuff, grabbing the runners.
That's what's
resellers, right, the money's in the runners.
Yep. Robbers. Robbers Air Jordans get him 12 years in prison.
Jeez, 12 years of anal sex.
An article written by Riley Jones for
You know what they're doing in San Quentin?
Gay!
Fucking in San Quentin.
Food and penis.
I never get tired of that drop. A Maryland man was sentenced to 12 years in prison for his role in a home invasion and armed robbery after being identified by Air Jordan Prince left at the scene.
Stupid.
WTLP reports that in June, 24-year-old Devontae Dixon was...
Devontae is definitely about to get some Dixon.
Dixon?
A whole lot of this.
I hope you like prison food and penis.
Devontae Dixon was convicted for the attack, which took place last November. Police say that Devontae kicked in a woman's apartment door and punched her in the face, demanding money while she held her young daughter.
You can't hit me. I'm a girl.
Sometimes I wonder.
Wow. Damn, the actual audio of the incident. The victim later noticed Devontae's picture on Facebook. Facebook get everybody. And Montgomery County police were later able to match a print left at her apartment with Devontae's Air Jordan 5s. Prosecutors had pushed for 15 years, but a 12-year sentence was ultimately handed down. A similar case happened last summer when a Kansas man was charged with attempted murder and the footprints of his Nike sneakers were used as evidence.
That's why your fives are so easy to get. They've been in murder charges.
Right.
I'm not so sure I want to wear these anymore.
Oh, well, them, yo, we can, they can find us.
They probably wouldn't, like, get Caesar. They probably would go to, like, a...
Bigfoot house?
Yeah, Bigfoot house. So they probably think it was Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Or Yeti.
Yeah. Like, they wouldn't even come get them. Like, oh, damn, Snuffleupagus back in jail again.
Wow.
Bird. Come get me, Bird.
Wow. I need some smack, Bird.
You can't hit me. I'm a girl.
Get it together, Grouch. Get a job, Grouch.
Get a job, Grouch.
Stepping over homeless people. All right.
Yo, what's good? It's your boy, Tony D2Wild, checking in once again. You are now tuned in to the number one sneaker show, the Sneaker Box Podcast, on SneakerBarDetroit.com.
Hello, sports fans. I'm Ron Burgundy, here at the desk of ESPN. And there were some things going on in sports today that will make your brain fall out of your skull.
Wow.
All right, before I start this, I want to say, Nike, the U.S., all the Olympic jerseys suck.
Was it iron on?
It's like, it's terrible. It's like, it's bad. They had Argentina out there looking like a brown paper bag. USA look like they got on women's volleyball bras.
Babe, them boys do look tight, dog.
Like, you can see Kyle Lowry's whole shoulder blade. It's bad. But the USA basketball team are really just destroying people.
Yeah, they beat China by, like, what,
50-something. But, I mean...
Then they play... China's huge. I mean, you know, they basketball team is really big.
Yeah, they tall guys, but they're big, tall, slow guys.
They had Yee out there training up. Kyrie got crossed, too.
Yeah.
But, yeah, they play China again on Friday, and Kevin Durant makes his unofficial Oracle debut.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he's about to get a lot of...
I heard the tickets were selling by the thousands now.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
He got booed last night in Staples Center, though.
No surprise.
Aroldis Chapman out here for the Yankees throwing 105 mile per hour fastballs.
It was a ball, you told me. Yeah. But they're about to trade him.
Yeah, to the Cubs, potentially.
Yeah, I really don't get where my Yankees are going, bro. It hurts. It hurts me. You know what I'm saying? Good old Steinbrenner is not walking through that door because he's in the dirt. Hal and Hank, they both suck balls.
Wow.
And daughter Steinbrenner, you just need to go ahead and get a job cooking.
So they basically run an organization like the Lakers are.
Yeah, you know what's
funny? You know what's great about the Lakers this year?
What's that?
Is that the Bus son, if they don't have a good season this year,
he's not leaving.
He vowed to step down.
He's not going to leave. It would be the first time somebody His sister
needs to fire him. She has the power to fire him.
I think Genie's pretty good.
Yeah, just bring Phil back.
But it's seriously like the same things because like with the Lakers, I really feel like, man, I would have gave Jerry West the world to stay forever. Yeah. Ever.
You see he's doing a Golden State?
Yeah, and with the Yankees, I think it's just time for Brian Cashman to leave.
Yeah.
He's lost his mystique, bro. It's over with. The farm league is terrible. I just have no respect for the Yankees, but I still love them. I can't leave them. I hate you, Detroit Tigers.
But I tell you, like, Jim Buss, I mean, when he said that, it reminded me of George Bruce Sr. when he said he wasn't going to raise taxes.
Oh, yeah.
And then he did. So he's not leaving.
He won't leave. But, I mean, the Lakers are actually picking, like, good prospects.
I like the Lakers team this year.
Yeah, they're young.
The only thing that's crazy.
I like a lot of young teams. The Timberwolves.
Oh, the Timberwolves look nice.
The Timberwolves are about to have a lot of great free agents for other teams.
The Pelicans are going to stink, bro.
Yep.
Buddy Hill is not that guy.
Nah,
I'll give him a chance.
And I don't understand what he's saying, though. That's why he got peanut butter on his gums and shit every time he talks.
Buddy Buck, too. Peyton Manning, I don't know if anybody's surprised, got cleared of HGH use.
Oh, surprise.
Just like he got cleared of that rape in Tennessee.
Yeah. What did he do, put his nutsack on somebody's neck or something? He did something crazy.
The trainer, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a female trainer.
Yeah.
Push her head for it.
He was like, is this enough Manning for you?
Ryan Fitzpatrick is out in New York flexing because he wants to get paid, and he knows they have no other option because Geno Green sucks. I mean, Geno Smith, whatever his name is, Geno Bad. Well, we won't be going to Charlotte for the All-Star game this year.
No, we won't, bro.
It's still up in the air about what.
I mean, how steep do y'all really think that is, bro? You know I am for the people, but what did the Hornets do?
It's just the state, period. It was like the what it was is it wasn't so much of punishing the Hornets, it was punishing like North Carolina because the government wasn't even trying to make a effort.
They kind of dug their heels in.
The Carolina Panthers still get to play there, right?
Yes. But they might not get a Super Bowl in Carolina.
Yep.
I mean, I'm just saying, like, the Charlotte Hornets are still there.
Yeah, but they lost a lot of money.
That's like a lot of money. Like
that's a lot of money.
That's a whole
they just
week.
Walked out of that city.
Yeah.
I just don't. I mean, I get the protesting, but, you know, they're still going to get it in 2019, they said.
Potentially.
Or as soon
potentially,
as 2019. If the law passes, what do? You ain't going to take the pro franchises from out of there.
Right. I mean, never know.
So, what did you really take from them? Like, you took one big day away from them. They can gradually make that money over time. You know what I'm saying? But
I mean, I guess they're looking at it like if I guess they're looking at it like if the NFL doesn't have the Super Bowl there, and then the NBA, like if all these organizations, groups, companies
just
start pulling out, then you know that affects them or something.
This isn't the music for that.
And Ray Rice said if he gets a contract, well, if he get picked up, he would donate his whole salary this year to domestic violence.
That dude is never getting picked up, bro. He actually just became the black sheet of NFL, bro.
Yeah.
And it just sucks because like dude just wild out one night and he'll never get back in the league ever, bro. You are the black sheep, Ray. You might as well just go ahead and start your own little backyard team, bro. It's not happening.
Yeah.
Chad Johnson is back in football. He's coaching for the Browns, is it?
Oh, the wide receiver coach?
Yeah.
That's dope. Wow. Actually, I mean, he was a good artist. I mean, you can't argue with that.
ESPN hired Randy Moss as an analyst. I cannot wait.
Randy Moss, actually, man, is a smart dude.
I cannot wait,
I can't wait for that either.
Two greats, Ken Griffey Jr. and Mike Piazza, got inducted to the Baseball Hall of Fame this weekend.
You see his suit?
Yeah.
Ken Griffey's?
Yeah. Bro, was it me or did Mike Piazza look like he been smoking some
He looked like De La Hoya, bro.
Yeah, It looked like he did a line right before he accepted it. Like, oh, man, this jacket fits so good.
Like, what is this, velvet?
Oh, man.
Holly Holm got mollywopped at UFC 20.
Yeah. You know, the only thing I don't get about the UFC
I don't
is,
even want to see her fight, what's her name, Ronda Rousey.
I don't think Ronda Rousey is going to fight, is she?
She's almost coming
back. She can't fight until November, I think.
Yeah, because of that suspension.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's so busy worried about her face and stuff, bro. But you do know you have to be a winner in order to be in movies.
Yeah.
You have to win.
They told her she's supposed to be Captain Marvel.
Who, Ronda Rousey?
Yeah.
But is Captain Marvel
a
girl?
A woman.
Yeah. Captain Marvel is a girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Guess what movie I'm not going to see?
Wow.
You can't hit me. I'm a girl.
I can do what I want, Ronda.
That's what she says to the villain in the movie. Well, I'm going to let you finish before I go.
Manny Pacquiao is returning to fight November 5th.
Stop your lying.
Why?
Yeah,
why?
What's this Crawford dude?
Does it matter?
Is going to suck.
But
Crawford. That's what he's fighting.
Terrence Crawford, is it like under a belt or under a certain division or anything like that?
It's a welterweight. I'm sure of it.
De La Hoya, bro. He lost that hand speed so long ago, man.
No, not De La Hoya. Pacquiao.
Oh, Pacquiao. My fault. Same person.
I still don't want to see it. I'm still not. What the?
What else? It was something else. Well, now breaking news. Michael Jordan has released an anti-gun violence statement and pledging $1 million to each of two organizations. Yeah, he believes he can facilitate change.
Yeah.
This is going across the ESPN screen right now.
Unless you're going to sell Jordans with bulletproof vests. You're not going to have any type of change.
Oh, no, that's true. But, I mean, Michael Jordan's doing something there. So.
He's been, honestly, from what I hear, he's always donated money.
Yeah. I mean,
He just ain't told everybody about it.
Which, I mean, that's cool, too. You know.
I mean, that is kind of cool because there's not a lot of
people. You don't become a billionaire without donating. You need tax write-off.
Yeah.
I mean, it's honesty.
No, I agree with you. I mean, I just hate when people do stuff for charity just to tell everybody they did something for charity because now it's not about the giving. It's about you.
Aroldis Chapman just got traded.
What'd they trade him for?
Ham sandwich.
Five-player deal.
It was probably nobody's.
To the Cubs.
What they were trying to do is they were trying to get the number one prospect from the Nationals.
Yeah.
Nationals not going to get that up, bro.
Le'Veon Bell can't stop smoking weed, so he might be suspended for 4 games again.
Just don't get it, dog.
Man.
Just Michigan don't get State. It.
I
think Michigan State football players are cursed.
Antonio Cromartie's career may be in jeopardy due to hip concerns. That just popped up on the team screen. Crow might be done. Crow is one of my favorite cornerbacks, too.
Yeah. Well, you know what's wrong with his hips. He done made like 30 kids. It probably popped out of place and never got back in there.
Yeah. Coach Dennis Green died.
Yeah, that's sad.
He was who we thought he was.
Yeah. Now, I didn't know a lot of things. I didn't know he was like this second winningest coach in his first 8 years as a coach. And then he's the second most winningest African American coach
behind
Tony Dungy. He was the man, bro. He was a really great mentor to a lot of guys, a lot of people who didn't have fathers, like myself, whose dad is still playing hide and go seek to this day. He was a great guy.
And I want to end with this. I would like to say, fuck the WNBA.
Oh, yeah, man. That was some
not, the basketball
not the basketball players.
The
league as
the
organization.
The people who run that organization and have ran it into the ground.
Because, the top salary for WNBA player is like $100,000 or something like that.
Yeah,
so to find them like $500 a game, it's technically detrimental.
Yeah, bro.
For protesting, like, you know what I'm saying?
They're protesting for something for real.
Like, these people are making – these people – are the reason that you have these funds. So I like, you know.
But that's just my point, though. Like, you just read that they pulled out, or the NBA pulled out of North Carolina. So it's okay for the NBA to protest, just not the players. But it wasn't even NBA.
Well, the NBA has protested all the time.
Yeah, they let the players.
I can't breathe.
Exactly. Like, so that's all they basically did. They did something akin to what the males did.
Yeah.
But for some reason, they got penalized for it. You got the cops at the one game. They left. Yeah, they didn't
want to work no more.
Yeah. But what's funny about that is I ain't never heard of a cop not wanting to secure a KKK rally.
Right.
I ain't never heard about nobody walking off of that. But, you know, but God forbid.
I've been hearing that some NBA athletes are going to actually, you know, help the girls out with their fines.
No, well, they rescinded it. They rescinded the fines. Yeah. But, I mean, the point is,
they shouldn't even went that far.
It's a dying league.
Yeah.
It's a dying league. And they're great. And their best players don't even play in the WNBA. They go overseas most of the time. Like Taurasi.
They get more money. Yeah.
They get way more money, tax-free. They get room and board and all of these things. Like, they really.
Adulation.
Yeah.
Give the ball to Monica.
Yeah. Now they just look like.
They look stupid.
Yeah.
That was terrible. It was a bad look.
You're already trying to get people to watch, and then you pull that.
You pull that. I'm like, man.
It's a lot of things that they need to do in order to shape up that organization, because they got a lot of great players over there. And just because they can't dunk and they can't do.
They have,
you know what I'm saying?
The NBA since
they talked about. They were talking about lowering the rim so the women can dunk. I'm like, man.
This penis party's got to go. Hey, hey. Ho, ho. That's right. This penis party's
got to go. Hey, hey. Yeah, I just. I mean, I wish the league success, because I remember when they first started up, and I used to watch the WNBA all the time. Cynthia Cooper, one of my favorite basketball players, period, man or woman.
Right.
The Yankees got number one prospect, Gibbler Torres from the Cubs, and number five prospect, Billy McKinney.
Oh, but guess what we're going to do with him? We're going to fuck his life up. Guess what, guys? You thought you had a promising career, but now you with the New York Yankees. We ruin everybody's life.
You about
now
to become the new Coke boy, strawberry.
You'll never
did
be
you see that? Did you watch
life.
That 30 for 30?
It was amazing, bro.
Yeah. Amazing. Doc Gooden?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I need to catch it.
Every time I seen it, I was like, Coke boy, baby.
Yeah, it was amazing, bro. All
right, well, that's about it for sports.
So, yeah, I got two quick things. One, anybody heard anything lately about Mateen Cleaves, his situation?
His rape thing?
Yeah.
I mean, who worries about what Mateen Cleaves is doing?
You can probably catch him at Fridays on the South Field on Tuesday night.
And then secondly, anybody seen the Wonder Woman trailer?
Yeah, I saw it.
That was actually kind of cool, actually.
I saw it.
I look forward to seeing that movie. As well as Doctor Strange.
Let me get past Suicide Squad first before I decide.
I hope that's good.
I hope they don't push it back again, bro.
I know they keep pushing. It's like the third time they pushed it back.
The only movie that I'm excited about is that Don't Breathe joint.
With the blind man. That comes out next month, right?
What?
Yeah,
that's dope. Right. It's this blind guy, and he's supposed to like have a load of money. And this dude gets this girl, another guy, to break in there. And he's actually a Stone Cold killer.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Like, basically turns out all the lights in the house so they can't, like, he knows how to get around. They don't.
In the dark, of course.
Oh, so similar to Arya Stark. Okay.
Yeah, similar to that. Right. Actually, I'm also on season 3 now of Game of Thrones, going back.
You a good one.
And watching everything.
And Ghost is back.
I don't have an Emmy.
On Power.
Yeah, Power.
Ghost is back.
I still haven't watched it.
And Survivor Remorse is back.
Yeah, man. You know what happened on Ballers, the second episode, they actually, like, messed up on the Fire Stick, and it's, like, one of the season 1 episodes now. I hope they fix that.
Oh, man. You know Roger Goodell? They say Roger Goodell is mad about the show Ballers. He doesn't support it. He don't even want the athletes on there.
They're going to be on there regardless. Yeah. They don't even listen to Roger.
Hey, I mean, he can't stop it. What's he going to do?
Nothing.
Oh, Game of Thrones music. When's that come back out? Next March?
Actually, way next year. Way next year.
And then they dropped this bullshit trailer, and it was just a bunch of like behind the scenes of them building and making stuff.
No, they actually got the real trailer on.
Do they?
On Facebook, the real trailer's on there.
Okay.
And then
see the way I'm making.
Dawn of the Walking Dead is starting back up August 24th, so that's going to take you into the Walking Dead, which I'm excited about. I'm really excited about The Walking Dead.
When Better Call Saul come back out?
Better Call Saul. You know, honestly, man, I kind of didn't like this season, bro.
You didn't? This season was better than the first season.
Nah, I don't like Better Call Saul.
Better
like
Call
that,
Saul
was
pretty good. It's getting better. But
it probably comes back out the same time.
Uncle Buck got canceled, bro.
Yeah, I'm happy for
that. How many episodes was it?
It was just one season.
It wasn't even a full season.
It got canceled like two episodes into the first season.
Yeah. You know what it was, bro? Nia Long isn't a TV show person. That was back in the Fresh Prince days. She kind of outgrew it. And then it was really, really corny. I felt like they wanted to kind of not be like, what was it called?
Blackish.
Yeah, they didn't want it to be like Blackish. And you know what I'm saying? I just think they made it too corny.
Blackish is actually funny. I love that show.
Yeah, but Blackish actually has a premise, and it kind of reminds me of a new age Cosby.
Yeah. You know? Can we get more of those shows, please?
I'm just mad that Mike Epps, like, gave up his role on Survivor's Remorse to do that.
So he is dead. Like, you watched the first episode?
He's dead.
So he's dead?
Yeah.
I was hoping that he'd just be, like, in a coma or something, man.
No, he's dead.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, I know he gave up his role for that. And when he died in the TV show, I knew he had something coming on. That's usually what happens. But, you know, you can always come back, bro. Lady Stoneheart.
I don't know how you gonna bring back.
Uncle
I don't know. It ain't no Jon Snow's to bring back.
Ain't gonna
Julian,
bring back
bro.
Jon Snow stuff.
Yeah.
There was something else happened too. I can't remember. But I hope that the Suicide Squad movie is good. Cause see the Ultimate Edition. Everybody, look. I don't think anybody in here was really thrilled to see Batman vs Superman. But the Ultimate Edition is way better.
I never said it was bad. I'm just a movie person in general,
six.
Man. I don't really care what movie it is. It could, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to watch it once. But I thought it was dope. I thought Wonder Woman definitely should have had a larger role. But it was for her movie. So
right.
She was in there for that 15 minutes or whatever. But that woman is
the Ultimate Edition is
so
way
fine.
Better. It's like two different movies.
Yeah.
It pushes up from a 6 to an 8 to me.
From a 6 to an 8?
6 to an 8.
Jeez, bro.
Is that much better. Also, too, what I just found out last night, and I watched it. You remember X-Men Days of Future Past?
Yeah.
There's a Rogue edition.
A Rogue edition?
She was in the movie. It's like an extra 20 minutes missing.
With Rogue?
With Rogue. Like, not just her, but the movie is slightly different also.
Yeah, I'm kind of...
It was actually better. I don't know why these movie companies make these movies and then decide, let's cut out this part. Because they are like both were better than the original versions.
Okay, I won't lie to you. If it's not really a part of the Marvel Universe right now, I really haven't been watching some of these movies.
Yeah.
Just because, like, the X-Men was dope. That X-Men movie was dope. But, like, if you're going to be Phoenix, I need to see more Phoenix. Like, the things that we grew up where... You know, you get up in the morning, you watch the cartoon, and then you get mad because it didn't start all the way over to the beginning.
Yeah.
Like the Phoenix Saga, all of those things.
But not the Phoenix from X-Men 3, though. That was weak.
No, I'm talking about like cartoon Phoenix when she started wilding out. And even when she killed Xavier, that was cool. But, you know, I felt like the one smart thing they did was they went back in the past. So they're still on the same
trajectory.
Yeah, but it's...
It's slightly different.
Yeah, I'm not really feeling it. I'm feeling more of these TV shows right now than I'm feeling with the movies. Power's starting off kind of slow. I want to know who killed the girl who put the card in his desk.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I definitely...
You see Kanan coming back on episode 3.
Yeah, Kanan's going to be back, but I wonder when Kanan's going to die. And I wonder what the young boy is up to.
Yeah, I
wonder...
think it's something up Dre's sleeve.
I wonder, does he just really want to prove himself?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I wanted to get to today? Have y'all I know we've seen the Air Jordan 31 by now, right?
That shit's ass.
The reactions.
I
was on the call Jumpman just to get his reaction. Like, y'all, like, what did you think about that?
I just
that
didn't,
shoot?
I don't understand it. Because that commercial, when they showed the commercial during whatever that was on TV. Yeah, when they showed the commercial during the ESPYs, I just knew that something was about to be fire or whatever.
When you bring back the band one commercial, it's like, all right. Yeah.
So I thought it was for the what the Jordan won.
All right.
Or the band Jordan won.
Yeah, yeah. Right. So when they showed the 31, I just didn't understand it. I wouldn't hoop in it. I wouldn't poop in it.
The only way that shoe was going to get sold is they put it with the ones and make you have to buy both of them.
Yeah, which people will buy the pack, but that kind of...
And then try to sell the 31 on eBay.
Yeah.
That shoe, $31. All the hype they put around that, man, I was like, this shoe better look nice.
And then I seen Jimmy Butler. He had on the Olympic colorway of it.
That's decent. And I barely want to give it that. That shoe is just trash. I don't know. I mean, maybe Tinker's lost it. I don't know. Like, it's, I guess I'm supposed to be impressed by the leather, the Flyknit, I guess. I don't know. I feel like I'm going to get, like, a text later on from Nightwing saying, well, you know, the technology in the shoe. Like, nah. It looks like shit, though. Like, it might be the most comfortable shoe you ever wear.
It looks like a 2K shoe creator shoe. When you get the endorsement deal on 2K and you just try to make it anything that got the Jordan logo on it for the commercial, and that's what it looked like.
I mean, I just think at some point you got to give the people more than just retros, man. You got to like, you got to leave some other type of legacy for the shoe company, cuz there's still tons and tons of shoes they can re-release in colorways that we don't remember from kids. But what are you going to do when you sooner or later run out or of releases?
Stop with the number Jordans and develop an actual signature athletes line.
Yeah.
That's a thought. I actually like that thought.
I'm not even happy with it being called 31.
Yeah, like, it's so dumb.
It looks more 71.
Yeah,
I'm not really feeling it, bro. I
mean, it still doesn't look as bad as those Curry Pedics.
Steph Curry has got ugly shoe of the year, bro.
Second
place is the Spike 40 for sure.
I mean, the thing about Jordan is you expect more.
Give Kawhi a shoe or give Russell Westbrook an actual shoe, but not just that lifestyle.
I mean, but who wants to buy the Air Jordan Sleep? Because that's what it's going to be if Kawhi Leonard.
I mean, we got to see what Kawhi Leonard we're going to get without Tim Duncan. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's his team now. It's a new league.
Kawhi's still going to ball.
Yeah, he's going to ball.
But he's just so boring. Like,
somebody on that team has to step up and be a market, you know, be marketable. So
Tim Duncan was never marketable.
But
somewhat.
He was the face of that franchise.
Man, I mean, you could be a face of
anything. They tried.
I'm the face of my family. You know what I'm saying? I don't really mean much.
Do you agree with that, Trufe?
Hey.
I don't mean much.
You said that.
You know what I'm saying?
He had to do to get that.
All those 31s are just horrible. I don't know, man. With all the pageantry they put around that shoe, and then he tried to correlate the whole band thing with it, it was just want to me. I didn't like it at all. There's a few people that liked it. You know, I don't know if it's because they really liked it or because it was a Jordan. It has all
and
three
then
logos.
It could be one of those things where it's like, well, it's better in person.
I doubt it.
But you never know because I didn't like the 30 until I seen it in person, and I was like, all right,
I'm trying to remember
okay.
What the 30 looked like.
The one with the 3X.
Oh, the 3X. The 30s, depending on the colorway, is decent.
Yeah.
Actually, I think the 28, 29s, and the 30s have been pretty decent. It's just this. I mean, but that was after a long line of Jordans that looked like trash too, though.
Yeah.
From like the 22 on now.
It was a regression.
Man, I don't know. They
maybe they just like try to hit rock bottom, so it's nowhere you can go but up.
They're trying to set it up. Like, is every shoe gonna be Flyknit now? Are there gonna be any leather shoes made from this point on, or is everything gonna be just synthetic materials?
Man,
because I'm kind of getting tired of Flyknit already. I'm just like, every shoe doesn't need to.
I mean, I'm not tired of it. It's just, the shoe still has to be designed a certain way.
Basketball shoes shouldn't be runners, bro.
Mm-hmm. I agree. I'm just like, dude, okay, enough of the Flyknit. Can we get leather again, or is that just too much to ask?
But you know the lighter the shoe, the jumper you high, man.
The jumper you high?
The jumper you high.
Release dates. The jumper you high. That's the title of today's show. If you want to make sure your shoes look just as fresh as when they came out the box, practice safe stunting and go to creptprotect.com and get your shoes some protection. What the hell is this? Oh, God. No. Is that Elvis? I don't know. Tom Jones would not be playing on this show. Release dates. Brought to you by SneakerBartyTrade.com, the number one source of sneaker news and release dates. That would be the first and last time you hear Tom Jones on this show. Wednesday, July 27th, you have the Nike Kobe 11 3D. That might be the ugliest shoe of the year. Horrible shoe. You have 3 Adidas Ultra Boost Uncaged coming out. You got the Collegiate Navy, Tech Earth, and Crystal White. And then you have the Adidas Ultra Boost Multicolor 2.0. Thursday, July 28th, you have the Nike Air Max 1 Ultra Flyknit. You got 4 colorways coming out. You got the OG Sport Red, bright crimson, black, white, and then you have dark obsidian black. Also on that day, you have Rihanna special edition Puma suede creeper orange camo. That's ugly too. I'm sorry, that's not another way to say it. And then you also have the Nike Air Max BW Ultra SE Olympic. Friday, July 29th, you have the Adidas Tubular Nova Prime Knit Triple Black. You have the Nike Air Max 1 Ultra SE Pure Platinum. And then you have two Adidas Tubular Doom Prime Knits, one in navy and one in gray. Saturday, July 30th, you have the Air Jordan Retro 12 OVO White and Gold. You have the Nike LeBron Soldier 10 Strive for Greatness. And you also have the Nike LeBron Soldier 10 Think Pink. You have the Filling Pieces Special Edition Puma Blazer Glory. I'm trying to remember what those look like. I think they look good, though. And then you have the Air Jordan 1 High KO Pure Platinum. It has that quilted look like the Just Don 2s.
Mm, I'll probably pass.
Yeah, easy pass. Monday, August 1st, you have the Jordan Superfly 5 colorways. I know everybody's looking forward to that. You have the New Balance 580 Re-Engineered Pack. And then you have the Adidas Crazy Explosive Solar Red. Oh, and they did their thing, too. They did. They just did something recently where they showed the D-Rose 7 and Andrew Wiggins shoe.
Oh, the Level 3 or whatever.
Yeah, something crazy. Depending on the colorway, it's a hit and miss. Anyway, Thursday, August 4th, you have the Nike 2016 Unlimited Collection. That collection includes the Nike KD9 and the Nike LeBron Soldier 10.
They should just make LeBron Soldier into LeBron shoe.
That should have been a 14.
Yeah, I like the prior ID option where you can put the flag.
Yep. Yeah, I like that. August 5th. Let me see. I'm trying to page. Yeah, the Nike Carry 2 ID, a limited pride, going on what you was talking about. Under Armour 2.5 USA. I'm trying to find something
next. The best shoe on this list next?
Yes, the Nike Air Trainer SC High Atlanta Olympics. Mm. They got pushed back. So that just gives me more time to get my money together.
I can't re-up.
Oh, why? You got to get your money up for these, too. You got the Under Armour Curry Lux Black Gum.
Oh, that is by far the worst shoe ever.
You are.
Under Armour is actually supposed to send me a pair in the mail. When you're a part of Team Light Skin, you get to reap the benefits.
Oh,
you
so know what
I'm the fact only that like, they got a lifestyle shoe, like, oh, my God.
So there's only 600 pair. There's only 600 light-skinned people in America.
I actually talked to somebody that's actually working with the lifestyle brand, and they're supposed to reach out to certain companies. Mm-hmm. When I get more information, I'll let y'all know. But certain people are going to be involved, like Kith and things. So, like, the lifestyle portion of Under Armour actually might not look as bad as we think. Huh. It might not be that orthopedic. Huh. Yeah, but it's been, like, all the big sneaker boutiques you can think of, those are the people that's supposed to get their hands on it.
Oh, so breaking news on the Sneaker Boss podcast?
Yeah, I talked to my guy Saturday when we was doing some gorilla stuff. And in Birmingham, we did a gorilla pop-up shop in Birmingham, and I actually bumped him to my mans, and he told me about it. But certain people wanted to, like, sit at the table, and they were like, you can't sit with us. So, you know what I'm saying? But he told me, like, some of the people, and definitely, like, Kith is one of them that will be a part of the lifestyle brand.
Right.
And it's actually going to be a good look, I believe, because my dude helped me discover, like, a lot of new brands and things like that. So I know if he takes his sense of style and all of these great sneaker companies do as well, that it should be dope.
Don't know Clue or...
Huh?
Clue doesn't work for Kith, does it?
Nope. Oh, Clue does not. Okay. You will not know my source, bro.
Oh, damn it. All right. Shout out to Clue, though.
Stephen A. Yeah,
that's Kitten Ace, bro.
Okay,
that's
my bad. Kitten Ace. Sorry.
If y'all go down there and holler at Clue Blanding down there at Kitten Ace downtown Detroit. I think that's right by the Nike factory.
Oh, he's light skinned. Right? He's getting one of those Curry Luxes too, right?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. When you're one of us and not one of you, you get orthopedic shoes in the mail.
There's only 600 people. Chris Bussard, he's getting one.
Yeah, shout out to Under Armour. Oh, and Permed Out Tico.
Yeah.
Permed Out Tico. Yeah, they supposed to send him like a beret too.
Tico's team Adidas. I don't know, man.
Yeah, I know. He might not get a pair. I don't know. He's light skinned though, so I don't know. Maybe a dilemma.
Well, Tico got a lot of Nike selling in my store.
Uh-oh. John Wexler is shaking his head right now listening to the show.
That's how you steal somebody's endorsement deal.
Hey, did you see some of his videos from Adidas this past weekend?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was out there, bro.
He was out there massaging Derrick Rose's kneecap.
Oh, my God. I heard he tried to hug James Harden and got tackled.
Did his ponytail get caught in James Harden's beard?
He grabbed his beard and another one just grew like he ripped it off. Another one popped out.
Oh, my God.
I heard Tico's ponytail got caught in the elevator and they had to hit the emergency button. I did hear that.
Oh, my God. Oh, man. What's up, Tico?
A.K.A. Quail Man.
Quail Man.
Oh, shit. All right. Saturday, August 6th, you have the Faces and Laces Special Edition Reebok Classic City Under Construction that will be sold exclusively at Gorky Park in Moscow. It will be available everywhere else on Sunday, August 7th.
I ain't going to Moscow for no shoe.
Air Jordan.
Ain't nobody coming to see you, Otis. Right.
Ain't nobody coming to see you, Otis.
Air Jordan Retro 1 High OG Yin Yang Pack.
Oh, yeah, my young boy Andre hit me up on Snapchat and asked me what did I think about it. I ain't really had no quarrels with it like that.
I mean, it's a black and white show. I mean,
it reminds me of Good Spy, Bad Spy, the New Balances that released a long time ago.
Yeah, I remember them.
Yeah, it reminds me of those.
Air Jordan Retro 7 Tinker Alternate. They actually, you know what, the more I see them, the more I like them.
You almost made me cuss at Tinker. Because I just think of all the bad that he did, and I don't get it. Maybe Tinker's alcoholic.
Going through some stuff right now. I don't know how you can make the mag and then make the Air Jordan 31.
Make the mag lace itself.
And then you come out with that? Like, I'm sorry. That's not the same person to me.
You got
to
get off the white horse.
Maybe he's bipolar.
Yeah, Tinker, you got to get off the white horse.
Oh, no. It's like,
if you want to ride.
Would it be crazy if he's a schizo? Like, get these two personalities? White
horse.
Right, here we go.
White horse.
You have the Nike Kyrie 2. Y'all horrible.
Yeah.
You also have the casual industry.
The whole time you read.
Caesar stumping his big ass foot over here like, why pony?
I'm like Blue in the Temptations. I'm just here to sing bass.
Man.
That ain't right. casual industry special edition. Brooks Fusion Fly Fight. Casual.
What?
I don't know.
What? What did you just say?
What?
You really like the blue fly.
High jumper.
Fly pelican fly. Just read the next one, bro. Monday, August 8th.
August 8th, Nike LeBron 13 GS comic book. Wednesday, August 10th. I shouldn't even read this one, but Air Jordan 31 USA, because I'm pretty sure it's somebody out there, that one guy out there. Thursday, August 11th, you get the Adidas D-Roll 7 Solar Red.
Who can believe that he's had 7 pairs of shoes and only played in 2 of them?
No. I would say the D-Roll shoe has had 2 Derrick Roses. I actually like that one, though.
I do, too. It's not bad. Saturday, August 13th, the Air Jordan Retro 14 Indiglo. The Air Jordan Retro 12 GS Baron. What? I actually like that colorway.
Hold on, big fella. What does this say right here?
Oh, this next shoe. Okay. The Nike Air Yeezy 2 Golden Child.
Ooh.
But it's a custom, like what's the name?
It's a custom, but it's not. Like, it's strange, but
it's not a Nike shoe, though.
It's not a Nike shoe, but
like Hinder. It's like Hinder. They did. Somebody made it. It's like,
but it looks like, I mean, it looks good.
But how many of them releasing?
I think
100. Oh, just 100?
I think it's 100 of them.
Man, well,
it's like black metallic gray type thing. Like,
let the hype begin.
It's crazy.
It's a gold pair, too. Or Golden Child.
No, that's not. That's the black pair. It's just called Golden Child.
It's like it's a gold pair.
It is?
Yeah. It's like a metallic gold.
I seen the picture. It was like a black pair, but it was called a gold.
Yeah, the Adidas D-Row 7 Smoke Gray. Monday, August 15th, you have the Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 Beluga.
Beluga.
Tuesday, August 16th. Okay, never mind. Wednesday, August 17th, you have the Adidas Ultra Boost Olympic Medals Pack. Friday, August 19th, you have the Nike Zoom KD9 Birds of Paradise. The Nike Flyknit Racer Volt. Saturday, August 20th, you have the Air Jordan Retro 8 GS Wolf Gray. Nike Air Max 90 Ultra SC Cargo Khaki. The Air Jordan Retro 5 Olympic. The Air Jordan Retro 5 GS Wolf Gray. Sunday, August 21st, you have the Nike Zoom Flyknit 96 Olympic. The Nike Air Force 180 OG. I actually like those. Friday, August 26th, you have the Nike Air Foamposite Pro Hyper Cobalt. The Adidas Women's NMD XR1 Prime Knit Clear Onyx. That is a European release only. And then finally, Saturday, August 27th, the Air Jordan Retro Low, Retro 11 Low Closing Ceremony.
That boy cold.
Yeah.
I wish it was a high, though.
Oh, that was the shadow that I seen. Like, it just was a bad picture. It is like a metallic gold.
Okay. So you saw a shadow of a nipple. You know how it's a nipple? Because I'm drooling.
There's a couple of shoes to look out for, like the Nike Air Max BW Tonal White Navy Brown, the Women's Air Max Zero Wolf Gray, the Women's Air Max 90 Iridescent.
What about this Crazy 8 Olympic rings?
Yeah, I don't know. I ain't really feeling them. But
we don't care about what you feel.
Oh, excuse me. Excuse me. Let's see, what else? That's pretty much it. The Air Jordan 6 Pinnacle Metallic. And Soulfly has a new Jordan collab coming out, too, so... Anyway, stay tuned to SneakerBarDetroit.com for more sneaker news and release dates.
Well, I can play the piano with my dick.
You've really been practicing that.
I have. I got chopsticks down, I gotta tell you.
You ever seen the video of the cat playing chopsticks with chopsticks?
Oh, my God. That's a visual I do not need in my head.
You ain't seen Ninja Turtles, man?
No.
Did I actually get a laugh out of Trufe?
Yes.
Wow. I'm impressed with myself.
Good job, White Ranger.
Thank you. Thank you very much. This is the Sneaker Box Podcast, Lady Sneakerheads of the Week, brought to you by Didi Negron and her Kick It With Didi 365 project on Instagram.
You so stupid, Juan.
Yes. Yes, you are, stupid Juan. I gotta start out. Oh. Start with the most important. I gotta give a big shout out to Mackenzie, my big assistant here. She's keeping me on track most of the time. Although I think she snuck over and got a chocolate. She wasn't keeping an eye on me, so I hit some stupid buttons.
That bowl is probably empty.
Yeah, almost. Oh, gotta give a shout to Lulu Shug. And I can't forget Tondre. Now, I don't know if I should give a shout or not to Kina Monet.
Frequent leaker.
The frequent leaker out here.
But I think her other problem dried up a little bit. She's. seems to be doing better, I think.
Oh, man.
Oh, God.
Frequent drinker.
Mm-hmm. The milk's gone bad.
The milk's gone bad.
Oh, my God.
Of course, I have to give a shout to Jordans are my plug. I'm not talking about what we're plugging, that's for sure. Sarita Biancita. Killa Cam 2. Gotta give a shout to Star X3, or is that Star 3 times, Star times 3?
I don't know.
She's 3 times important in my book. Hey, Juan, I got a question for you. What's your favorite kind of donut?
Lady cream.
That
sounds like a frequent leaker.
Oh, my God.
Woo. I'm so glad we're on the same page, my friend.
Oh, yeah.
Hey-o.
I got to give a shout to...
That was a nice alley-oop, though.
You like that?
Yeah.
Got to give a shout to Brio8. And, of course, FlyCheck23. Or is it XXIII?
I'll go with 23.
And here's the sound she makes later. I.
Hey.
Boom. So those are this week's Sneaker Box Podcast.
Don't forget about Tanita.
Oh, our girl Tanita down in Dallas. Thank you.
Yeah.
Elana Adams.
I was going to give her a personal one, but, you know, since you bring it up.
Yeah.
Tanita down in Dallas. She's going to come up.
Yolanda Adams putting a praise on it.
Yeah.
I'm going to put a praise on it.
I don't know if Yolanda's coming, but I do know Tanita is going to pay us a visit.
For what I heard, she's not doing much else, so, I mean, she got a number of free time.
Well, you know. We'll see if she can book an extra ticket. I don't know if she can afford it, though.
Tell her bring me some
she might
some
be her Uber rolls. Driver. I don't know. It's crazy.
If she prays really hard, she could come here.
Ooh.
So those are the Sneaker Box Podcast, Lady Sneakerheads of the Week, brought to you by Didi Negron and her Kick It With Didi 365 project on Instagram. If you want to be a part of this, be sure you send send your Instagram name to Rashawn, to Caesar. And you can also find me and like me on Facebook. I'm Barry White Ranger.
Yes, sir.
I hope to see y'all soon.
Yes, sir. Yolanda Adams might be the most infamous inside joke on the show.
Ever.
Nobody knows what that is about. I'm not going to tell you.
Never going to explain it, huh?
Never going to explain
it. Not on duty.
Nope. Should have been here in the studio.
Not on duty.
I'm going to put a praise on it. Get out of here, Yolanda.
Oh, my goodness. Shout out to Erica Campbell. Shout outs. Our main man, Mike Rich, see you in Atlanta.
I don't September. Even really work here.
We're going to be down there, huh?
Be crazy, man. And Mike.
We going on the road trip.
That's what makes this so difficult.
Mike, please take that weekend off. Do not, I swear to God, if we get down there and you got to work, I might call
punch
in your
you
job.
In the face.
We I'm going to call in a bomb for your job.
We going to
this,
see.
Our road trip has to be like filmed so that we can put it on.
Yes, Rome.
Snicker Barty Trey.
Gonna holler at her, man, Rome.
Yeah, I'm going to hit up Jerome.
Yep, Rome good.
I say Jerome's in the house. Watch him out.
And Jumpman Rollin' too, so that's going to be an interesting trip.
He going to have on the 31s.
Knowing Jumpman, he probably will.
I'm going to spill your mocha latte on him.
Follow Mike Rich at Rich_Mike23 on Instagram. Check out his YouTube channel, Rich's Kicks. Sean, Paper Chaser Williams, and D. Wells was the live. I need to call them. Check out the past and present episodes on iTunes and Android podcast apps. Most Sports Talk with Christopher Henderson, a.k.a. Hollywood Code 85. He's doing better. He's out of the hospital, last I heard. So shout out to him. Check out the website, mostsportstalk.com, and check out Chris's YouTube channel by searching for Hollywood85_. Juan Neal and the Loose Cannon Lifestyle Clothing Label. Go to shopLCLS.com to check out the selection of sneakers, t-shirts, and apparel. You can follow him on Instagram at Loose Cannon Brand. If you live in the Metro Detroit area, you can go to a store and check out his shoe wall in person. The Loose Cannon flagship store is located at 195 West 9 Mile Road, Suite B2 in Ferndale, Michigan.
Y'all losing, man. I had a pair of snakeskin Supreme Air Maxes on there. Put them up at about 10 o'clock, sold at 11 o'clock. Y'all losing. Go to the website. Get some shoes.
There you go. Some best shoe wall in Detroit. I'm just gonna leave it there. And remember to use CryptoSec, the official partners of the Sneaker Boss Podcast, to clean and protect your shoes from anything life or nature throws at it. Get the most out of your sneakers. Practice safe stunting and go to CryptoSec.com to get your shoes some protection. You can also follow them on Instagram and Twitter at CryptoSec. We are 12 away from 100, man. I'm gonna plan something big though. I want to give like. Oh, technically 11 away.
Yeah, 11 away now. Yeah. We have 11 away.
So.
And remember, people, it's 90 degrees out here. Wear some deodorant.
Yeah, it's a lot of people.
No BO is the best BO.
Oh, man. Go.
It's too hot out here for all that. So, anyway, I'm Caesar, Juan, Trufe, Freaking Leaker. We'll see you guys next week. We out. Juan.
Yeah, Caesar.
What's wrong?
My shoes are dirty, and I have a date tonight. If she sees my dirty shoes, she'll call me a poop and slam the door in my face.
Juan.
Caesar, why'd you slap me?
Bro, all you have to do is use the Crepe cleaning kit and Crepe rain and stain resistant barrier spray. And you'll be all set for your date tonight.
Wow, Caesar. My shoes look amazing. And that jelly from that donut you spilled on my shoes rolled right off. Now I'm ready for my date, and I might even get laid.
Ha! I'm sure you won't get laid tonight, but you'll look good walking home alone, and your shoes will look great. Practice safe stunting. Go to creptprotect.com and get your shoes some protection. We all know why I'm going to need it tonight.
Hurt. Hurt.